I started playing in the fifth grade and wanted to play a lot earlier than that, but my mom wouldn't let me because she was afraid I'd get hurt. So that's when I started playing and started playing quarterback from the very beginning and just kind of stuck with it. I was on the kickoff return team and I wasn't even the deep man. I was like kind of one of the middle guys and they kicked it to me and I ran it back for a touchdown. So I guess that was a sign that football was my sport. I mean, it's just something that's, you know, that I'm passionate about. I've always done it since I was young and, you know, I like winning. I don't like to lose. So it's something that, you know, I'm competitive. I'm a competitive guy, you know, whether it's football or anything else. So. What they may not know is that we're roommates now. So we're really good friends. We were good friends even when we were competing for the job, but you know, we're even closer now. We live together, me, Jamie, Zach Markham, who's a receiver, and Chris Burkhalter. But we all have a house together, and we're all really close and great friends, and we don't let on-the-field stuff get in the way of our friendship at all. I mean, they're just great guys. They're the ones that kind of got me coming to Bible study last year, and we try to encourage other people on the team to come. We had one last night, and I think we had about probably 25 or 30 football players there. So, and we had probably 200 people total. So that was really good. Just all the stuff that goes on in Africa, especially Darfur, is something that I've studied a lot lately. Being a political science major, I've gotten a chance to read some books on it and write a few papers on it and stuff. But it's unbelievable the things that go on over there, and people in America have no clue about it really because it doesn't get very much media coverage. So it's something that I try to raise awareness of and make people conscious of what's going on, you know, hopefully to make a difference one way or the other. Kind of what you said, I've got, I think, 4 or 5 t-shirts that I can think of off the top of my head that are, you know, support the causes in Africa. And, you know, there's a couple books that I've read that are just unbelievable, some of the stuff that's in it. It's just, you know, it really jumps out and shows you the brutality of what goes on over there. And I've recommended those books to several people, and they've read them and kind of, you know, it's kind of changed their lives the way that it did mine. So I think just that, you know, wearing t-shirts, and then people have no idea what the t-shirts mean, and they ask me about it, and that gives me a chance to tell them, you know, what's going on. My ultimate goal right now is to make it to the NFL, but you know, when I was younger growing up, I wanted to make it to the NFL just so I could have a lot of money and, you know, just so I could have a nice house and a nice car and a boat and all that stuff. But now I still want to make it to the NFL, but it's for different reasons, so I can have enough money to where I can help, you know, help even more the causes over there in Africa and hopefully even travel over there one day. It's a bracelet from Uganda. It's from an organization called Invisible Children, and what it does is they help orphans in Uganda, in northern Uganda, that their parents have basically the almost the entire population has been wiped out by AIDS and war. So there's tons of orphans over there that just have nothing really, and you know, it's an organization that helps them out and gives them a place to stay and gives them food. And you know, if it wasn't for organizations like that, they wouldn't even have a way to survive. So, you know, I wear it on my wrist, and it used to come off, but I actually clamped it on with pliers, so it doesn't come off anymore. I'd have to cut it off now, but it's been on there for a year and a half ever since I got it. My family as a whole has just been everything to me. My parents, my brother, my grandparents, my aunt and uncles, we all live on a big farm. And you know, the whole family's there, so I've been really close to my entire family growing up, which is neat. But you know, if it wasn't for them, I wouldn't be where I'm at. I wouldn't be the type of person that I am. And they've just, you know, raised me going to church and raised me to be a good person, to care about other people. So I think that's where it all comes from. I just like having other things on my mind besides football sometimes. You know, during the season, it's a long season. You know, it's 4.5, 5 months or something. And it seems like every time somebody wants to talk to me, it's about football. So I try to, you know, do other things to get my mind off of that, and whether it's listening to music or talking about music or just hanging out with friends, you know, I like other things other than football. I am passionate about football, but I have other things too. Shrimp, grilled shrimp. I saw some corned beef hash today in the cafeteria that just looked awful. Probably Gatlinburg. Trip to the beach that didn't turn out so well. It'd have to be, I don't know that I could pick one moment. All of last year was pretty special for me. I've got several of them. Having people name the starter over me at two different colleges and, you know, sitting the bench is never very fun. Bowling Green, Florida, conference games. I've got a lot of things I'm looking forward to this year. It means a lot. You know, it's a big honor, and I'm proud of it, but at the same time, it's preseason stuff, which doesn't mean a whole lot in the grand scheme of things, so, you know, whatever. A Long Way Gone by Ishmael Bia, I think is how you pronounce it, but it's about genocide in Sierra Leone. The Devil Came on Horseback, it's about genocide in Darfur. I'd have to look through my collection. Twilight. I was forced to watch that the other night at my house with about 20 people, and it was absolutely awful. The Program, great movie. Travel to Africa, help out as much as I can over there. Travel all over the world pretty much. Up off the field, my passion for Africa, Darfur, Uganda. I'd like to be remembered for that more than what I've done on the field.